What is going on, everybody? You are mocking my voice right now.
Sorry. Okay.
But you know what? Continue. We're in it. We're in it now. There's no going back. No extra chance. But we're also in the Game of Thrones finale, season one, episode 10. So the Game of Thrones finale of season one, the season finale. I'm super excited to get into this. Before we do, I just want to mention that if you guys want to watch our full-length reactions, we do have a Patreon. You just click the link down below and check it out. We would love to have you there. We love and appreciate everybody who is already a part of it. We've got the Batman full-length reaction up. We've got 7, 8, 9 of Game of Thrones up. By the time you're watching this, we should have some Mandalorian episodes up as well. So feel free to check us out there. If you like the video, leave a like. And if you want to subscribe to stay tuned for more, it would really mean a lot. Before we get into this episode, Isaiah, just, you know, what do you remember of the season so far?
Some of the biggest things, Ned is dead. That's like, that was crazy. That was huge. Ned's dead. Robb sacrificed 2,000 men to distract Tywin while he went and attacked...
Captured Jaime,
yeah. Which was a turn of events because I didn't know if they were going to, I didn't know how that was going to play out. If he was going to get Tywin or if he's going to get Jaime. Yeah, you got Joffrey disregarding his mother's wishes to not kill Ned. Like, she fully expected him to let Ned live from what I saw.
Yeah.
And he basically said, I'm king and this, I do what I want. Tyrion bargained with some hill tribes to let him live in exchange for metals or gold and weapons and such, but they requested to Tywin that he actually fights with them on the front lines. And considering that now Jaime's captured, Ned's dead, and the Dothraki might be on the move again. We saw that blood magic was being practiced on Khal to bring him back because that wound got super infected and festered and he was on the verge of death. Mm-hmm. We're gonna see. There's a lot that could develop in this episode, man. I mean, the name's Fire and Blood.
Yeah, that's a cool name.
Well, question for you, Cam. You know, because like the cows and them are like always half dressed and stuff. Mm-hmm. Why doesn't
I can feel the smile in your mouth.
Why doesn't naked and baked rhyme, but pony and baloney rhyme? That doesn't make any sense to me. And comment down below if that, you know, you wouldn't naked be naked. You comment down below if you got an answer for that. But I mean, without further ado, let's get into the Game of Thrones episode. Glad I gave Cameron a brain aneurysm right before. But yeah, I got nothing left.
All right, here we go. Okay.
Waiting to see.
Yeah, no, I know.
Yeah. Oh my God. I didn't think they were going to open it up on that. Holy shit.
Keep your mouth shut, boy.
I'm not a boy.
Now she's a boy.
Boy, we're going north.
Dude, you might just create two savages. Sansa and Arya might just become demons. I would. Saw my father decapitated. Oh, this boy dreaming again. He ain't walked in a minute. Three-eyed crow. I like that they keep... I'm interested to see where this dream leads because we keep calling back to the same... It's the same sequence, but it gets a little further every time. Yeah, I know. Shut up and just show us.
I came to see father. How many times have I told you he's in King's Landing with Sansa and Arya? He was down here. I saw him. Saw him when?
In a dream?
When I was sleeping. Here, Shaggy Dog.
Shaggy Dog is his direwolf.
What a terrible name. Ghost is the best.
Ghost is...
You both miss him.
I don't think it's as bad as the name Lady. R.I.P. Lady, but...
RIP Lady. Wait till Lady Stark finds out. She gonna fuck everybody up. Or cry. It's also the same. She gonna cry it out, then she gonna fuck everybody up.
Damn, she's like broken.
but not as dramatic as some girls are. And women. I've seen women cry hard over a ticket.
Some of them.
Some. She's bold, though. She's
I know what you meant. I mean, like, there are men who can get pretty dramatic, too.
Yeah, I've seen Cameron cry a lot.
Rob. Not me. I'm a man's man.
Rob. I mean, he's emotional.
Yeah, see, well, there you go.
Emotional.
Oh, dude, no, not the time for that. Father gets decapitated.
It's about,
and you're gonna say emotional.
No, that's the most emotional damage. That's actual emotional damage.
Yeah, I mean,
the lion Sansa's like his balls off and... Wait a minute. The boar did all the rest. Is he freestyling right now? Bars.
He might have written.
Tell me, which do you favor? Your fingers or your tongue?
Your grace?
Fingers or your tongue? If you got to keep one, which would it be?
Every man needs hands, your grace.
Good. Tongue it is.
Your grace, please. I won't. Your grace, please!
She has to be realizing, like, we fucked up. We shouldn't have given this kid all this power.
Walk with me. I want to show you something.
No, please, no!
This one's your father. Look at it and see what happens to traitors.
That's fucked.
Look at him!
Again, I hate this fucking kid.
Well...
How long do I have to look?
As long as it pleases me.
One of those heads is George Bush. They needed molds of people's head, and they had like a George Bush mold or something. And you could see it clearly if you looked.
That's actually crazy. Oh!
I think it's George Bush. It might be somebody else, but I think it's George Bush.
My armies, and kill your traitor brother.
Or Bill Clinton.
I'm going to
Bill
give
Clinton
you his head as well.
Or maybe he'll give me yours.
Oh...
Woo! I'm telling you, you're raising a savage, bro. You don't.
My mother tells me a king should never strike his lady. Sir Meryn.
Here's the thing.
What? Are you gonna say at least he doesn't hit women?
I was gonna say, but like, no, well, you have a. Your mother is a queen that used to get abused by the king. Like, right. There's gonna be some. Balance, you know what I'm saying? Not balance, but there's gonna be an area where she's gonna feel something for her. I feel like
maybe.
I guess I'm speculating, guys.
It was the dragons we bowed to, and now the dragons are dead. There sits the only king I mean to bend my knee to.
Okay,
the king of the north.
I like it. I like it. I can get behind that. I can get behind Rob right now. Right now. I know y'all gonna be like, he wants to get behind Rob. You don't even know. You don't even know.
You never
right
know.
Right now.
Am I your brother? Now and always.
Now and always.
Always and now. King in the North.
The King in the North.
What happens when you cut the head off of, you know, they all would have probably considered Ned to be the best king in the North, but
he's dead. Prison. You got him who he didn't even bend his knee to the one guy. He's like, I'm leading it. He's like, then leave. And the guy was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's got that part to him where he's like, I don't give a shit. Listen, he's like, I'm getting justice. I don't give a shit if you're going to help me or not.
Right.
So come with me or not. We going to figure it out. It's like, the leadership qualities, man. You can get people to follow you. That's leadership qualities.
Why is the world so full of injustice?
Oh my gosh.
He was clawing at my door.
Like you. He's gonna watch along with this.
Yeah.
There are no men like me. Only me.
Yeah, I do not see anyone else just chained up.
Yeah, there are no men like you. I can promise you that.
How did he come to fall from that tower?
I pushed him out the window.
Well, you made it to it. Get your nose from the fucking Easter basket. Back up. Stop it.
You were right about Eddard Stark. If he were alive, we could have used him to broker a peace with Winterfell and River Runner.
What I said last episode was, bro, a bargaining tool.
You will go to King's Landing.
And do what?
Rule. You will serve as Hand of the King in my stead.
So he is hand. So,
yeah.
Okay, cool. Remember we were talking about that before?
Yeah.
Why not my uncle? Why not anyone? Why me?
You're my son.
Tyrion becoming the Hand of the King? Interesting.
In place of Tywin.
My son. Where is he? I want him.
Oh, I forgot about that
part. Where is he?
And this looks like it's not a great scene.
Tell me.
What is there to tell?
How did my son die?
Don't get her angry.
They say the child was...
monstrous. Twisted. I pulled him up myself. He was scaled like a lizard. Blind. With leather wings like the wings of a bat. When I touched him, the skin fell from his bones.
As if he's a dragon? Here's the thing.
Monstrous.
The first half was...
But only death can pay for life. You knew okay. The price.
Where is Khal Drogo?
He better be fucking alive. Also, her first half of description was that of a dragon. Scales like a lizard. Leathery wings like a bat.
Right.
That's a dragon description. Like, I don't know what else we want to call it. Like, yeah, that...
But later.
I want to see him now.
Told you, as long as you're paying for life. Yeah, but then what the fuck was the whole horse thing?
Yeah, what the fuck? But blood magic, she might need the blood, enough blood to do the magic, but it might take... Right. So I was like, I feel like she's going to tell you have to sacrifice your life. And she was like, no, not your life. I was like, a horse is too easy.
Drogo. Sheikh Mishrakiani. Why is he out here alone?
He seems to like the warmth, princess.
Yeah, that's why.
So your blood, so...
You asked for life. You paid for life.
This is not life. When will he be as he was?
Sun rises in the west, sets in the east. When the seas go dry, when the mountains blow in the wind.
I'd want to rip her face off.
I would fuck her up. Holy shit. I sacrificed my kid and
you get a vegetable. That's pretty much what she's saying. He's alive. That was the deal.
Get out my way, son. Oh, put out son. The word. They'll send out ravens. People will come after you. Do you know what happens to deserters?
They get diabetes. Oh. Oh, deserters. He's saying like people that leave.
I won't let you go.
I'll run you over.
No.
Well, I guess he will, huh?
Move! No! Move! No! I said move. I can't believe you done this.
Sam told us everything. We're sorry about your father.
But it doesn't matter. He took the oath. He can't leave.
He surely can. And he's going to.
I pledge my life and honor to the Night's Watch. For this night and all nights to come.
I'd be like, yeah, I remember saying that. Goodbye. I got weight. My problems are exponentially larger than what y'all are dealing with right now. Oh, Cal comes back. I mean, I probably won't, but damn. Like, I don't like seeing him like this.
When the sun rises.
Oh, she's losing it. She's losing it.
And sets in the east.
Do you blame her?
Her eyes roll back. The sun fucking rises in the west. And she starts flipping shit around. Everyone's like, oh my god.
I wish I could breathe underwater.
I love how you just had to throw that in there.
Because I had to.
I mean,
You guys are creating savages right now. You got a woman that just lost her man and baby. You got a wife
to finish her man off because out of mercy, you know, like she's not gonna. She's basically saying, "I don't want you to be this vegetable." She just killed him.
What's the point? You're conscious. You're dead. You're consciously dead.
I think she did him mercy.
Right? Yeah, mercy killing.
And what would you do, my friend, if you found yourself sitting up there?
I must be one of the few men in this city who doesn't want to be king.
You must be one of the few men in this city who isn't a man.
You can do better than that.
That was kind of good. Don't. Eunuch's mad.
You stay over this lot, boy. And stay. Or I'll lock you in the back of the wagon with these three.
I mean, you can get why he's doing what he's doing.
Smart, though.
He ain't no squat. Look at him. Looks like a girl. I bet he stole that sword.
Let's have a look.
That boy's killed somebody already with said sword, so...
I already killed one fat boy. I bet you never killed anyone. I bet you're a liar. But I'm not. I'm good at killing fat boys. I like killing fat boys.
That's awesome. That was a...
Oh, you like picking on the little ones, do you?
Ah, yes! And there's like an older brother, Sivir.
When I hit that steel, it sings.
You know who this guy is?
You're gonna sing when I hit you?
No, not really.
That's Robert Baratheon's bastard, Gendry.
Oh! Hammering steel, yeah, hammering an anvil for 10 years, yeah, okay.
And winter is coming!
I'm sure I'll hear that a billion times. Winter is coming.
Well, it is.
I know, that's like, oh, people always like, yeah, winter is coming. I'm like, oh, yeah, okay.
The only time you can't say that is when it's here, right? I mean, even if it just ended.
Summer is coming!
I want you and your wolf with us when we ride out beyond the wall tomorrow.
Oh. You made him, So he's riding out, so he's going to be there, okay.
To find out what's happening.
The Night's Watch will ride in force against the wildlings, the White Walkers, and whatever else is out there.
Don't know if it's so smart, but okay.
Are you a brother of the Night's Watch? Or a bastard boy who wants to play at war?
I wouldn't say he...
Goosebumps. I don't know.
But I wouldn't say like he's playing at war. Like, come on, bro. Like, you're downgrading what he would be into. He'd be in war with the Lannisters.
No, like, yeah, I get that. But like, you know, also, I think he's trying to say that this war he's getting in is nothing. That's why he's using the word playing compared to what he thinks might be a big threat.
Yeah.
You don't understand.
Don't ask me to stand aside as you climb on that pyre. I won't watch you burn.
Is that what you fear?
Yeah, she can't burn, buddy. That was a poor choice of words.
I mean, he thinks she's about to go kill herself.
Yeah, but like, don't kiss him on the cheek. It's kind of weird.
There, you know, you can get in there and that whole thing can collapse on you. There's many different ways she could.
That those who would harm you will die screaming.
You will not hear me scream.
I will. But it's not your screams I want. Only your life.
That's a savage quote. Yeah. She said, I don't even care if you scream, bitch. I just want you dead. Period.
Yeah.
Like, the fuck? You get that? She was like, you're not going to hear me scream. No, it don't matter. It don't matter. And you're probably going to scream. That fire going to hurt. How are you going to be able to sing? I'll be impressed if she can sing through her death. That's kind of crazy. Well, she got both. Your death and screams.
Yeah.
And she won't burn because fire can't kill her.
Well, we know she hasn't burned in the past. Look at that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Game of Thrones does not disappoint. Oh my God.
Season one finale.
Let's get now. I don't want to take no time, dog. That episode. Here's my thing, bro. Here's my thing. I struggle every time I see an episode. I'm like, all right, this might have been like the dopest episode. I'm like, holy fuck. Now this episode, nah. And I'm gonna say it like that. That might have been the coolest cliffhanger to a series I've ever seen. Like, if I was watching this live, knowing I couldn't see the next season, I would have
lost. I still have goosebumps.
I would have
seen this show so many times.
My back is shivering. When she came out of the fire and she had all the dragons hatched, I was semi-real, non-animated based. Let me say that. Because animation's easier to create like the wildest things. Out of non-animation based series, that was the coolest cliffhanger. Catelyn turned to basically a savage. Rob get emotional.
Everybody declare him king of the north.
King of the north. John basically committing to the wall, which is a bold, you know, basically saying that, you know what, this is a war. This is my war. That's their war. This is my war. I'm here.
And they're going beyond it now.
Sansa boldened up. I mean, Arya standing up for herself. I mean, it's like I'm rooting. Like I'm this as far as the series has gone right now. I can see. I would say that most people at this point in the series were rooting for the Starks. They were saying like, you know, I like they like Snow. I know he's like, you know, whatever. They like Jon. They like Rob. They want, you know, Rob's in this war against Tywin and everything. Avenging his father along with Catelyn. You got Sansa, who I'm like waiting to do some crazy shit in the Capitol. Arya, who basically had two people press her and she killed one person. She was like, and she used it to her advantage. And right. Now she's befriended the
Gendry.
Yeah, Gendry, the bastard of Robert, which is huge because he even sees like, this is Castle Forge Steel or whatever. Like this, who'd you steal this from? It was a gift. He goes, it doesn't matter at this point. So now you have a possible friendship developing between them. And now you have the Khal's dead, but Khaleesi now has her own people basically. And it's creating a different dynamic because like I was saying before, there's a lot more women now I'm not saying there's more women than men, but you can see the balance was a lot different. When they were showing Khal Drogo in the beginning, you always saw men, and then you saw hints of women when they were getting fucked. But now we saw women and men, so it's like, and they bowed before her because I mean she had three dragons
and just survived on fire throughout the night that they witnessed somebody else screaming to, you know. So and that's the thing is they said that the dragon eggs were petrified. It was stone. They couldn't hatch.
And she made the most probably one of the most savage statements in the whole episode. She said, Mira is like, you're not going to hear my scream. She goes, I don't want your screams. I want your death. That was it.
She's been saying that was savage lines all season. You know what I'm saying?
She was, but like that line.
No hands.
But that line was like,
yeah,
that's the tipping point. Like she's like, now it's my brother's dead. My husband was dead or is dead. And my child's dead. All I have is these dragons and my people. She goes, whatever. Like now this, oh man,
dude,
that throne, so
different ways this show can go.
And now I imagine she's going to try to start maybe possibly targeting the throne because you also can, I mean, you can't correct me if I'm wrong because you've seen the series, but from an outside person's standpoint, when I'm watching this, she is really like, I mean, you have Catelyn technically. You have Catelyn, but she has Rob, right? Mm-hmm. Who's people declare king of the north or king in the north. Daenerys, Khaleesi, whatever you want to call her, she's like the first like female real leader that's like probably gonna target the throne. Like, I know, like I'm getting this for my dead husband who was supposed to get it for my child who I had to sacrifice. And she's queen of the dragons.
And like, she's also the last Targaryen.
At the wall. Her father,
the Mad King, was on the throne. So
she has every reason to be like, fuck all of you. This is mine.
Well, and, I mean
man.
Crazy. The show man. Is going to get crazy. I'll tell you that much.
What a banger of an episode. If all the finales live up to that of each season, then holy shit. I don't even know. I mean, we have so much more to get into, like episodes. Yeah. And it's like, this was the first season. I can see why the show was so popular. And I'm almost glad that I don't have to wait for next season's to release.
I hopped in when, like, I think I was able to binge watch season 1 through 4. And then I had to wait, like, you know, a week at a time or whatever. And then like months between the next season or years between the next season or whatever. It's so you are so lucky that you get to just like go to the next one, and really get through it.
And it makes it fun too. Cause it's like, I got you guys in the shout out to all of our, you know, subscribers, people that are watching this, our Patreoners. It's like, man, I get to watch it. Camera gets to read me comments about people that are like, yo, just wait. Like, he doesn't even know. And I'm like, I know I don't even know. Like, that's what's dope. Is like this show, like, you know, there's a lot of shows that people gloat and talk up and stuff. They're like, just wait till he finds out this. Just wait. And it's like, you know, they don't always live up to expectations, but like Game of Thrones, you guys have not been lying. And I believe, I mean, it's in the reviews and the amount of people that have watched it and enjoyed it. And I mean,
we have the passionate fan base, like the
passionate, we have people that have seen this series that are like, I mean, again, like shout out like the YouTube and Patreon crowd. We have people that have seen this series that are willing to watch us just because I haven't seen it and you get to help me view it. Like, that's crazy. Exactly. Like, there's not many shows that create a fan base that's like that hungry.
You'll be able to go back in time one day and see
how little I knew at this point. Was, I'm sure
you'll be able to see, you know, your reaction to Ned's head getting cut off for the very first time. You'll be able to see, you know, Jon Snow going beyond the wall. You'll be able to see.
I know my jaw was dropped when I saw her come out with the dragons. I was like,
she looked.
My head was like, what? I was like, what?
No pun intended. That was fire. But
bars. Not everyone can come up here. All love to all of you know, people that watch it, comment, you know, subscribe, like the video, share with family and friends. If you haven't done it already, bro, subscribe. Patreon's in the link. Come view Cam and I Tuesday into Wednesday night, technically. Tuesday, 12 a.m. Wednesday, 12 a.m., Tuesday, 11:59 p.m. Come view us. I'm on Twitch. You know, him and I are playing It Takes Two, and we're going to keep that pretty consistent. I think we're going to also add in another day because we're going to try to do, like, playthroughs of games. We were talking about Portal. Neither of us have played It Takes Two, so Portal, Cam has played, but we're going to try to get some game nights in. Come on over. Interact with us, man. Ask us questions. Like, listen, regardless of the – you ask this question about the reaction channel. Ask this question about us, man. I love talking to people. So, you know, I've had some chat engagement. It's a blast. Makes it super fun. I'll let Cam know questions that come on to him. But, I mean, other than that, sheesh, what an episode. What a season finale. I'm excited for season 2. I can't believe I'm already through season 1.
Yeah. Wow. I know. It's going quick already. Like, it is. I can't wait for this to be completely – wrapped up in you to get through everything. But yeah, if you guys like the reaction, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to stay tuned in for more. It would really mean a lot to us. If you're watching this on YouTube and you do want to see our full-length reactions to this episode, you know, 8, 9 and 7 as well, we do have the Batman on there full length. We should have some Mandalorian episodes on there, and by the time you're watching this, there should be even more Game of Thrones episodes. So if you guys want to get ahead and see where we're at currently on Patreon, you can go ahead and check it out there. We'll probably be a little bit into season two by the time you're watching this. So
yeah.
Yeah. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.
Peace.